Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. It's Friday, April the 6th, 2012. This is the Friday edition of the DeMartez Show, and today is Good Friday. Do you feel good? Here's James Brown with I Feel Good.
I feel nice. The sugar and spice. I feel nice. The sugar and spice. So nice, so nice. I got you. When I hold you in my.
Okay, so let that hold you for a little bit. That's James Brown, I Feel Good. Well, today on the DeMartez Show, I'm going to give you the American Idol backstage scoop. Yeah, last night was elimination night, and someone went home. You probably know who it is, but I'll give you the backstage scoop on that. And also, Whitney Houston's daughter, Bobby Christina, is slipping into darkness, and the family calls for an intervention. Also, I posted on the site yesterday, Cherie Whitfield from Real Housewives of Atlanta has been fired from the show by Bravo. I'll give you details to that. And also, Real Housewives of Atlanta star Kim Zolciak has a new song. You know, her first song was Don't Be Tardy for the Party. Remember that? Don't Be Tardy for the Party. Yeah, that crazy weird song, but now she has a new song, and her new song is called Love Me First. And I'm gonna go out on a limb here, and I'll play Love Me First for you on the show. Okay, so let's get right to it with the American Idol backstage scoop. Now, it was definitely a rough night at American Idol. Now, DeAndre Brackenzack had to say goodbye to his idol dream. Joshua Ledet nearly passed out from a sudden illness, and Phillip Phillips looked bored to death. Now, DeAndre still had a positive attitude, okay, after the show, and he admitted he wasn't totally caught off guard by having to say goodbye. So it's almost like he knew it was his time. Now, if you're not into American Idol, I'll share with you who DeAndre is and his singing voice and let you decide if you think he needed to go home. So this is his performance from Wednesday's show. And I think you'll like the song that he's singing. Here's DeAndre. Yeah, I like it, but America didn't like it. So they voted DeAndre off. So he's no longer on American Idol. Now, the backstage scoop in all of this, okay? So DeAndre told E! Entertainment that he kind of felt it a little bit. He said that his style, you either love it or you hate it. And you know R&B is so unappreciated right now, nowadays. I really want to bring it back, so I kind of had somewhat of a feeling. Things happen for a reason, and it's not the end. Just gotta keep fighting. He also went on to say that he agreed with the judge's decision 100% because they did not use the save on him, and he says that he's grateful. So, yeah, good sport, right? Joshua Ledet, our Louisiana homeboy. Yeah, Joshua was feeling a little ill. He was slumped in the couch during commercial breaks. Stagehands were by his side with water bottles doing their best to keep him going until the end of the show. Didn't know if Joshua was going to faint or vomit. And it wasn't no surprise that during Kelly Pickler's performance on the show, he took a break and went backstage. Also, Phillip Phillips' attitude on the couch seemed nothing short of bored as he slouched He drummed his fingers together and smacked on gum, barely giving the audience any love when cameras weren't rolling. And you know, to me, Philip Phillips should have been the one to go home. And if I could vote against certain people on American Idol, I would. I so would. But that's the backstage drama on American Idol. So Bobby Christina, yeah, slipping into darkness, and her family calls for an intervention. Now, since her mother's death, Bobby Christina has been on watch by her family. The Houston clan recently held an intervention for the struggling celebrity daughter, who has quickly slipped into the darkness. According to Radar Online, the site says the 19-year-old is at risk of falling the same fate as her mother, since lately she's been smoking quite a bit of weed, popping pills, and drinking out of control. Everyone is sick about Chrissy, one insider said. Her aunt Pat got a number of family and friends to come to Atlanta and have a serious talk with her. But sources say family members are afraid the intervention hasn't been much of an impact. One source is saying that at this point, Clive Davis has gotten involved and encouraged the teen to go to rehab. Since Houston's death, Bobby has been suffering mood swings and out of control behavior. Wow, Bobby Christina. And I guess this is good news. You know, Tyler Perry has taken Bobby Christina under his wing, and she's going to be on an episode of For Better or Worse. That's one of Tyler Perry's latest TV sitcoms, so I hope that helps. The darkness. Yeah, she's slipping into the darkness. I really don't know what that means, but it sounds pretty scary. So pray for Bobby Christina. So, Real Housewives of Atlanta, Sheree Whitfield has been fired. Bravo fired her. Yes, that's the network that houses Real Housewives of Atlanta. And basically, there was a meeting in New York, and they did not re-sign Sheree's contract. So she's gotten the boot. You can read that blog. It's right here on the site. If you scroll down and look where it says older entries, you can go to past stories, as far as you want to go. But read that about Sheree. But the big news is Kim. Yeah, Kim Zolciak. You know, don't be tardy for the party, Kim. And I don't understand Kim. I really don't. Not her singing. I just can't put my finger on it, but it's weird. But she has a new single, and it's called Love Me First. And I'm going to play it for you. So what I want you to do right now is just sit back. I would say relax, but I don't know if you can. But here's Kim Zolciak, Love Me First. Now, you know Kim cannot sing, right? Don't know where I'm going. I'm out in the cold wind. Gotta fight against the storm. Defeat me. I'm standing here a stronger woman, making changes in my life. Now I'm learning every day. There ain't no other way. Before I love somebody else, gotta love me first. Before I give another try, I gotta reveal my life. Okay, before I love somebody else, I gotta love me first. You know, that's all I'm gonna say about that. So you heard it right here first. I'm sorry. That was Kim Zolciak, Love Me First. Okay, well, that's it for today's show, the Friday edition. It's Good Friday. Hope you have a wonderful day. Remember, today's going to be the best day of your life. Something good will definitely happen to you today. So what are your plans for the weekend? Well, for me, on tomorrow, I'm going to have a family gathering with lots of food, crawfish, fried chicken, fried fish, dirty rice, mac and cheese, potato salad, boiled goods, all that good stuff. That's how we're celebrating for Easter, and of course Sunday, Easter Sunday, I'll be in the church house, most definitely. So whatever you're doing, hope you have a wonderful time. Enjoy yourself, and remember, the real reason for Easter, of course, is the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. You know I gotta represent on that. I'm gonna leave you with D. Montrell singing his latest hit, simply entitled Jesus. Yes, very appropriate here. And he's supposed to sing this at church on Sunday. I'm really looking forward to that. It's the a cappella version. Again, have a good day. Thank you so much, so much. I appreciate each and every one of you for coming to dmartez.com, listening to the show, and reading the blogs. Hit me up on Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Yeah, come to the site every day. Remember, DMartez, I love you listening.
Your heart goes beyond what I understand. Grace goes beyond what I comprehend. Love makes me who I am. There's no other name I know. Your heart goes beyond what I understand. Grace goes beyond what I comprehend. Love makes me who I am. There's no other name.